गुड मॉर्निंग ग्रेड नाइन, लेट्स गो फॉर सेट 4.2. फ्रॉम 4.1 स्टूडेंट्स, लेट मी टेल यू, 7th एंड 8th प्रॉब्लम इज रिड्यूस्ड फ्रॉम योर सिलेबस. सो वी हैव सॉल्व ऑलरेडी 6 प्रॉब्लम्स, 7th 8th इज रिड्यूस्ड. सो दैट्स द एंड ऑफ 4.1. नाउ वी आर गोइंग फॉर 4.2. सो फर्स्ट क्वेश्चन इज, यूजिंग द प्रॉपर्टी ए अपॉन बी इज इक्वल टू ए के अपॉन बी के, फिल इन द ब्लैंक्स. फर्स्ट लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय दिस. Now between A and K there is multiplication sign. That means if you are multiplying numerator by K, you need to multiply denominator also by K. Then only these two ratios remain same. Alright, so you have to observe by which number this has been multiplied to get this answer. By the same number you have to multiply this number also so as to get this answer. Are you understanding? Okay, so simply we know that 7 into 4 is 28. Or by which number 5 upon 7. I want to get here 28. So by which number I have to multiply? You divide it 28 by 7. 28 by 7. What you get is 4. So this is multiplied by 4. Then only you will get 28. Isn't it? So if denominator is multiplied by 4, you need to multiply numerator also by 4. So 5 into 4 is 20. So ideally your answer over here will be 20. You got it? You can write this for your reference. Okay? Solve each blank separately and then write. Now see, this ratio is also equal to 35 by dash. Now 5 is multiplied by which number to get 35? Now we know 5 stability is easy, so you can directly tell 5 sevens are 35. But to find it out, it is better you divide this number by 5. Then you will get by which number 5 is multiplied. Are you understanding me? So if I want to find out, like same I am doing over here, first let me divide 35 by 5. So 5 ones and 5 sevens. So 5 upon 7, this is multiplied by, this is how you get 7. 5 into 7 is 35. Because we are multiplying numerator by 7, we need to multiply denominator also by 7. So we have 7 sevens are 49. So your answer over here will be 49. Are you understanding? Similarly now, first we will divide 35 by 7. Now it is 3.5 upon 7. You know it is 7 ones and 7 0.5s are, because 7 5s are 35. So you multiply 7 into by 7, 0.5. So when we multiply 7 by 0.5, you get 3.5. So 5 upon 7 into 0.5. This will give you 3.5. So you have to multiply numerator also 0.5. Are you understanding me? So 5 5s are 25, and after one number point is there. So your answer would be 2.5. Have you understood how we have calculated? Okay. So if you are multiplying, if ratio is to be kept constant, if you are multiplying one number, numerator by any number, you need to multiply denominator also by same number. Or vice versa. That means what? If you are multiplying denominator by any number, you need to multiply numerator as well, so as to keep the ratio equal or same. Is it clear? So here you get 2.5. Similarly, can we do this? First we will divide 4.5 divided by 9. We know 4.5 it is. We know that 9 ones are and 9 0.5s are. So you have to multiply this number by 0.5, then only we'll get 4.5. So we now have 9 upon 14 is the first ratio. This we are multiplying first by 9 into 5, isn't it? 9 into 0.5. Just now we have calculated. And this also should be multiplied by 0.5. Okay? So how much is 9 into 0.5 is 4.5. Or 0.5 is half of 9. You are multiplying this by half. Isn't it? So 14's half is how much? It is 14's half, we can say 7.0 or 7. So this will be, because 14 5 is 70, you know, no? So 7.0, or this would come to be 4.5 upon only 7. See, 9's half is 4.5. So 14's half will be 7. You can multiply by 0.5 or you can multiply it by 1 by 2 also. This also is easy for you to understand. 1 by 2. 9 ones and 9 4.5s are 2 ones and 2 sevens. Got it? Okay. Now we know that 14 threes are 42, isn't it? So this should be multiplied by. Now I'm doing it directly. 42 divided by 14 is 3. So 14 threes are 42. So this also has to be multiplied by 3. 9 threes are 27. So it is going to be 27 upon 42. I hope you are understanding. Okay. Now look at the last one. It is 3.5 divided by 14. So as to get 3.5, 14 should be divided by which number? That I am finding out. So first let us go by 7 twos are and 7 0.5s are, isn't it? So 2 ones are and 2 0.25s are. So we are going to multiply by 0.25. So 9 upon 14 into 0.25, if you do, you are going to get 3.5. Just see how it is. 0.25 into 14, if you do, 5 4s are 20, 4 2s are 8, 9, 10, then 4 0s are 0 and 1, into you have 5 and 2, 25. 0, 5 and 3. After two numbers point is there, so you got 3.5. That means if I multiply 14 by 0.25, I am going to get 3.5. So by which number I have to multiply this? If I am multiplying denominator by 0.25, I need to multiply numerator also by 0.25. So 9 5s are 45, 4 carry, 9 2s are 18, 18 plus 4, 22. 9 0s are 0 and 2. After two numbers, point is there. So ideally my answer would be 2.25 upon 3.5. So here should be 2.25. Have you got it? It is as simple and as easy as that. Alright? Okay, so let us go for question 2 from this. Now look at the second question. Find the ratios. Ratio of radius to the circumference of a circle. Radius is given by r and circumference is given by 2 pi r. So ratio is of radius to circumference. R upon 2 pi r. RR gets cancelled. You have 1 is to 2 pi. Only 2 pi remains in the denominator. Now question second, there is little problem in your textbook. So you write down this question. It should be the numbers denoting the circumference. Now why is this change made? Circumference unit is in meters or centimeters. And area is in centimeter square and meter square. So ratio is always taken of similar quantities. And therefore, these two are not similar quantities. So the ratio of the numbers denoting the circumference to the area of the circle with radius r, that ratio we have to find out. We are finding the ratio of numbers. Alright. Now circumference is 2 pi r, area is pi r square. So you have 2 pi r upon pi r square. Alright. So in this case, pi pi gets cancelled, 1 r gets cancelled. So we are left with 2 by r. So the ratio is 2 is to r. I hope it is clear. Okay. Let's go for third and fourth problem as well. Now look at the third, ratio of diagonal of a square to side of a square, and side of a square is given as 7. So side will be 7, but diagonal we know that it is root 2 into side. So it will be root 2 into 7, 7, 7 gets cancelled and you have root 2 upon 1. So ratio is root 2 is to 1. Now again there is mistake with fourth problem. See, we can't say it is a mistake, but perimeter and ratio, this area, they have different units. One is in units only, like meter and centimeter, and area is unit square, centimeter square or meter square. So the ratio can be of numbers. Okay, make a little change. They have already given length and breadth. Now ratio of perimeter is to area. Perimeter of rectangle we know 2 into L plus B divide or upon area is length into breadth. So substitute 5 for length and breadth for 3.5. You get 2 into 5 plus 3.5. 5 plus 3.5 is 8.5. 2 into 8.5 becomes 17. And here 5 into 3.5 becomes 17.5. So your ratio is 17 is to 17.5. If you want to remove this point, you can multiply by 2. So you get 34 upon 35. So either you write 17 is to 17.5 or you can write 34:35. Okay, so with this we end with the second question, I guess. That's all from my side for today, students. Pause the video, take down the questions and solve it very neatly in your notebook. Thank you.